Hello children, in the previous sessions we were discussing on the lesson friction. There we discussed what is this friction, what are the advantages of friction and disadvantages of friction as well. In today's session we shall be discussing on the method of increasing and reducing the friction. As I said you all, the frictional force or the friction what is present children, it is both a boon and as well as it is an evil. We studied the reasons in the last session. So we have to increase the friction in few cases or in few aspects of our daily life, whereas the friction has to be reduced as well. So let us see or study the examples where we are increasing the friction and where we are reducing the friction. In the first case, we shall study few examples to increase the friction. All these examples, what I have stated here in order to increase or decreasing friction is not something new to you children. It is the things what we do in our daily life. But we may not be aware of what the thing what we are doing is in order to increase or reduce the friction. So we shall just know those concepts now. First is the sole of the shoes. We need to increase the friction. First let us think, why is the need to increase the friction? It is because, best example I will tell you is, if you are walking on the floor which is slippery, so you cannot walk easily. Every step you keep, you become very conscious. Consciously you walk. So in such cases we need to increase the friction so that you can walk firmly, because if you keep your leg you will slide and fall down. So in that case you need to increase the friction so that you can walk firmly. How do you increase the friction? You cannot avoid walking on the slippery. Yes, you can avoid, but in few the floors will be too smooth, the granite will be so smooth that you may slide and tend to fall. In such cases, how to increase the friction so that you grip firmly on the floor is, you have observed the sole of the shoes. It is not smooth. You have some markings or grooves on the soles of your shoes or the slippers. Why is it so, children? Because to increase the friction, you may not tend to fall. If you are walking on a smooth surface or a slippery surface, the grooves or the marks what you have on the sole of your shoes will give you grip to stand or walk firmly. So in the soles of the shoes, the grooves or the grips what we get are made to increase the friction. Even the tires of the vehicle, any vehicle tire, even the bicycle tires, if you consider children, it is not smooth surface. Yes, no? Why? Because again the same reason as we studied in case of a shoe or the slipper. It is again to increase the friction. Why? Because while you are driving, it is not always that you have the tall roads. You may have the ups and downs and all. So if you suddenly slip a small stone while riding, all that, you may not lose the grip and fall down. So the tires, is rough surface of the tires or the cuttings what you can see on the tires will help you in increasing the friction and hence get the grip to drive. Next, the brake system of the vehicle. This is very much interesting thing, children. How the brake system of the vehicles work? So unless and until you press the brake, or in case of the bicycle which you are riding, unless you apply the brakes in case of two wheelers or in the cars, children, the lever of the brake, when you touch only or when you press on, what we say, the brake pads will not be in touch with the wheel before you apply the brake in any vehicle. Once you apply the brake, what will happen is the brake pad will immediately touch the wheels and the rim, it will bring the motion of the rim to rest, and hence the wheel comes to rest or it stops moving, children. So that is how it works. That is the brake system of the vehicles. Next we have the kabaddi player applying sand. This is very much similar. Even you all play kabaddi. Yes, when the player, when he attacks the opposition team, you might have seen the person will just take the sand and just grease his hands, rub his hand with the sand, and then go attack the other team. Why is he doing so, you think? It is because when he has to touch or when he has to escape from them, if it is too slippery, because if the sweat and all the hands become slippery, it's not so. In order to avoid that, if you touch the sand, you will get grip to escape and hold. it is easy for him to catch, because if it is sweating, just imagine if it is watery or sweating, if you hold a person, easily they can escape from your hands. Why? Because it is smooth, slippery. In case if you touch the mud, you hold, you will have a grip in order to hold. So again, the reason is, of course, to increase the friction. Even the gymnastics, or you might have watched the Jambu Circus, children. People, you can see the jumping jumping from one rim to other and holding the support, they jump. They do all such interesting or things, no, children, in order to entertain the people. There also the people will grease their hands. Why? Because in order to get the grip, because they will be panic if they are sweating. Again, the same reason what I gave here with respect to kabaddi players. If you are sweating or something will happen, you may not grip to hold, or else they tend to fall. It is very dangerous because they will be in very great heights. So they apply some coarse material. Coarse material means some rough material. Maybe what they are applying, some rough material in order to get the grip to hold the things, even in gymnastics, you know. So all these are, you can state as many examples you know in order to increase the friction, what you are doing in your daily life. So these are the points in order to increase the friction. And we also understood what is the requirement of increasing the friction. Next, after understanding this, we shall move on to or learn what are the methods or necessity to decrease the friction. Why you need to decrease the friction? It is because, suppose if you are the same, yes, children, what is the necessary to reduce the friction means, you might have experienced opening the gate or closing the gate of your house, the front situated gate. Sometimes what will happen is it becomes too tight, if you have observed, it becomes too tight. Then what your father might do, he may go apply some oil there to the hinges of the gate so that it will move smoothly. It will move smoothly. Even if the door or the gate is making too much noise, the oil or it is greased in order to for the smooth movement of the doors, and also it reduces the cracking sound what comes when it is opened or closed, children. So this is one of the just example what I gave you to reduce the friction. Next is sprinkling powder on a carom board. Yes, you all are familiar with the carom board. You all play as well. So before hitting the pawn or starting the game, what you do is you sprinkle the powder on the carom board. And then why? Because if the friction is there, but we are trying to reduce the friction by sprinkling the powders on the carom board. So when you strike the pawn, what will happen is the pawn will move smoothly towards the pouches, and then you can get the point. So even though you hit with the striker and the pawns are not moving, means the friction is more, means it is of no use. Your aim is to hit especially the red pawn to the pouches. Yes, no? So children, in order to reduce the friction there, we are sprinkling the powder on the carom board. This is one which is very much familiar to you. Oil on hinges of the doors, as I said you, maybe the door windows or the main doors, gate, anywhere, children, in order to reduce the friction, to make it move smoothly without any cracking sound or that irritating sound, what they do is they put the oil so that the friction is reduced and the smooth movement we can observe there. Next, use of grease between moving parts of the machines. The tailoring machine, if you have seen, children, what you pedal here, nowadays electric machine has come, but I am talking about the mechanical movement. They move their heads, the legs, and they rotate the wheel structure in that machine part, and then sew the cloth, stretch the cloth by moving the cloth. So it may be hard to pedal, or even when you are riding the bicycle, what will happen is, when you are feeling difficult to pedal, even though it is a straight road, what you do is, if you take it for the service, what they do to just apply grease or oil to the near to the pedal so that the movement becomes easier for you. The friction will be reduced, children. Like this, as many examples you can give, thinking on your own in order to reduce the friction. So these are few points in order to increase and as well as decrease the frictional force. And as I said, you are applying oil, grease, simply whichever oil you want, you cannot apply, especially in few machines or machinery parts, children. So the substance which we are adding or substance which we add in order to reduce the friction are called lubricants. You know, this word is not new to you. You might have heard lubricants they will put. If you have seen the repair shops of these two wheelers, cars and all, no? They apply greasing or their hands will be black in color. Why? Because they often touch the grease and oil things, no? So their hand become black in color. So the such things what we apply in order to reduce the friction, the substance is called a lubricant. So what is a lubricant? It is a substance which is reduces the friction, if you say it is enough children. So that is about the lubricant. So this we understand what is the necessity in order to increase the friction, decrease the friction, and few examples for understanding the both. And we also studied what is a lubricant, that is, it is a substance which is used to in order to reduce the friction. So this completes the topic increasing and reducing friction.